So, Twitter's provided me a lot of interesting things, including the VidCon harassment and garbage humans posted up by Anita Sarkeesian on June 26th of 2017. So that is today's date. I'm going to go ahead and read through this article for you guys and give you my perspective views as to what Anita has done being wrong versus what Sargon of Akkad does and being wrong, because I do know that Sargon of Akkad has made videos about Anita criticizing her viewpoints and questioning her ideals versus calling her actual human garbage. Because we all know by now that's exactly what Anita is. And before anybody else goes and calls me a hypocrite about this kind of shit, I'm gonna say, yes, I've done my own video about Anita Sarkeesian. She is literally low-hanging fruit by this point. She is the whore that everybody walks into and walks out of, not disappointed, but very much so shaking their head. Yes, Anita is that type of person because there's so much videos counter-arguing against her in being that bait that providing any further videos about her is going to literally be regurgitating the same shit people have posted up before over and over and over again. And I'm not talking about myself. I'm talking about people like Thunderfoot. Of course, Sargon of Akkad. I think Undoomed has done one. Bearing's done one. A lot of the bigger YouTubers have done one. I believe Bane may have done one. I do know that Sierra McCord has done one. Honey Badger's Radio may have done one. At least everybody who is in the video game or the nerd culture itself has done a video against Anita Sarkeesian. Game developers have done videos against Anita Sarkeesian, calling her out on her shit that she clearly doesn't know. But yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and give you my perspective viewpoint as a feminist versus Anita's perspective viewpoint as a feminist, and read this article to you guys because I find that this article itself is both insightful in the mindset of how Anita Sarkeesian really operates versus what really transpired. And hopefully, I could actually find the link to the video, or at least to a video about Anita Sarkeesian calling Sargon of Akkad a human garbage and a shithead or a piece of shit, something along those lines, when he's just sitting up the front row, quiet, to listen. Something that feminists in general tell men, shut up and listen to me. You need to shut up and listen. You need to shut up and listen. You need to shut up and listen. Well, you know what, Anita Sarkeesian? You need to shut your fucking trap and listen to another feminist for a goddamn change. Anyways, let's go ahead and pick apart your article here. On VidCon, harassment and garbage humans. Anita Sarkeesian for June 2016, 2017. Or 26, 2017. Well, I cannot date. To kick off the Women Online panel at VidCon last Thursday, the moderator posed the question, why do we still have to talk about the harassment of women? I replied, because I think one of my biggest harassers is sitting in the front row. All right. That's not what you said. At least not on the panel, at the very least. But the fact that you think one of your biggest harassers is sitting in the front row just shows how little you really understand how the internet works. Sargon of Akkad is a big YouTuber, yes, but he's not one of your biggest harassers. No. Anybody who is against what you have to say, who's criticized your work in the past and will continue to criticize your garbage ass excuse of work in the future is one of your biggest harassers. So that's everybody who's against you. He showed up with several others together. His group took up the two front rows at the panel. Their presence was plainly not, as one of them later said, in an apology video he posted to Twitter, to give us a chance we never gave them and to hear us out, but was instead to intimidate me and put me on edge. They will no doubt plead innocent and act shocked at what they characterize as the outrageousness of such allegations. This, too, is part of their strategy, gaslighting, acting in a way intended to encourage me and others' targets to no doubt ourselves and to wonder if all of this isn't just in our heads, But to anyone who examines their patterns of behavior with clear eyes, the intentions of their actions are undeniably apparent. And look at that. Oh my gosh, look, they actually have a camera because they wanted to actually record this to judge it further on what you were saying and verify if it's actually something to target or if it's something to bring awareness of in general, not just for women, but the men who go through online harassment as well. And I'm going to point out something here, Anita. You've used something similar of this characteristic deadpanning and judgment before on TJ, also known as the Amazing Atheist, when he had posted up a counter pledge against your pledge to get $200,000 for your craptastic 5 episodes of Women of History, all 5 women being actually bullshit. Yeah, actual bullshit women of history, not just any women of history, because there's a lot more women of history than you let on in those 5 episodes, but actual bullshit women of history, and accused TJ of being sexist when his pledge was to help out women's health organization, to help women in third world countries, not to stuff your fucking pockets. And what I find to be more outrageous about this is that you had bigger companies backing your shit when TJ was trying to help out women in third world countries. Something that I strongly support to this fucking day as a feminist. I'm not sitting there trying to line my pockets with cash. If I want to line my pockets with cash, I'd actually work in getting a job. Getting a real job. Go back to school and getting a bachelor's or master's degree to get my pockets lined with fucking cash. I am not sitting there bitching about how somebody put up a pledge drive to help women in third world countries against you as being deemed sexist and misogynistic. What you're doing right here is the exact same bullshit. It is very apparent that all these people in this audience are there to shut up and listen to you. And the first thing you go and say, you call out Sargon of Akkad, calling him a garbage human and a piece of shit. And this is all for an abuse panel. And an abuse and harassment panel. What you did is the very fucking definition of hypocrisy. It is hypocritical of you to sit there and discuss about abuse and harassment. And the very first thing that falls out of your fucking trap when you opened it is abuse and harassing slogans. I think I'm using that word wrong. You are sitting there and calling one person human garbage. You're sitting there and calling one person a shithead because he's sitting right in front of you to listen. But you know what? You're a victim of the abuse and harassment of online bullshit that you can't just go on without actually being fucking triggered by looking at one of these fuckers' faces. Yeah, I'm gonna have some news for you, Anita. You're not the only one who suffers with online harassment and abuse. So you need to stop playing that victim card because everybody goes through online harassment and abuse at some point. And when everybody does it, I guess that makes everybody a victim. Even the men who post up these videos to counter-critic your own stuff. I mean, after all, what's the problem with actually trying to cash in on being a victim? Oh yeah, it makes you a fucking idiot. It makes you a hypocrite. And the biggest part of it all, it makes you a fucking loser. Like, you want to know what a loser looks like, Anita? A true, dedicated loser to the factualhood of loserdom? You're the fucking leader of that loser village. Carl is a man who literally profits from harassing me and other women. He makes over $5,000 a month on Patreon for creating YouTube videos that mock, insult, discredit myself and other women online. He is not alone. He is one of several YouTubers who profit from this cottage industry of online harassment, anti-feminism. Together, these people have millions of followers who are regularly encouraged by the videos and tweets of these individuals to harass me and other women who make videos daring to assert the basic humanity of women, people of color, trans folk, and members of the marginalized groups. No. No, 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 no. This is where you get everything wrong, Anita.
Everything wrong.
Men, yeah, they do harass people online. People online. Sargon's videos are not just women about his anti-feminist semantics, as you've claimed. His videos also target men. His videos also target current events, such as the bullshit that Sharia law is looking to be passed in the United Kingdom. Something that you, as a quote-unquote feminist, should be looking into and fighting against. Not against people of Sargon of Akkad, who's making it very relevant and to the point that this shit should not be passing to begin with. Instead, you sit there and call him human garbage. You want to know what human garbage looks like? Why don't you go look in a fucking mirror for a change? Fuck. You know, look past that egotistical veil that you created around your own ego and your own fucking eyes and actually look in that deadpan mirror. Look in the dead-looked eyes that your reflection is giving you and watch them shake their head at you for being so fucking idiot. For being so low. That you are accusing a man, an innocent man, who is currently sitting in your audience as being a harasser when you harass him right there in front of everybody else on a panel against harassment. Sargon of Akkad is not a threat to women. He is not a threat to the people of color or, you know, all races in general. He is not a threat to the trans folk or the LGBT community. He is no threat to those people. You know who are? Feminists like you, fuckwit.
Because of the constant flood of threats and harassments I have received over the past 5 years simply for being a woman who argues for the basic humanity of women in a deeply misogynistic culture, I went for a very long time, rarely participating in public conversations.
Bullshit. Bullshit! You are charging people about 20 grand for you to go out to their public speaking locations. And you're, deeply ingrained misogynistic culture, air quoting that, is literally around nerd culture, and you're afraid to bring up nerds because you do know that nerds were the easiest targets and are still the easiest targets to pick on to today's standards. And you know what? I'm a nerd who's not going to be afraid to fight back. I'm the nerd who's not afraid to bite you on your damn hand because you have nothing to offer me. I am the feminist who's not afraid to stand up against other feminists like you and tell you to shut the fuck up. You don't know what the hell you're talking about. If I know anything, nerd culture has been the most accepting group of people in history. And you know how I know this? Nerd culture literally started with sci-fi. My grandmother is a huge sci-fi fan. In fact, every time I go over to her house, growing up at her house, her channel was always on the sci-fi channel. Always. Sci-fi. Sci-fi, sci-fi, sci-fi. My grandmother went to sci-fi conventions. She still does today. Sci-fi conventions in general. Conventions started because of sci-fi conventions. And you know why sci-fi conventions are so important and so accepting? And especially the nerd culture with women? Accepting with women? It is because sci-fi conventions came out due to the fact women were the ones who started it. Women were the ones who pushed for it. And women are the reason why we have such conventions today, like VidCon, AnimeCon, YaoiCon, FurryCon, BronyCon, so on and so forth.
So, yeah, the only thing that's misogynistic in cultures today would be feminists saying things are misogynistic when things are not misogynistic. And when they say, oh, yeah, that's not misogynistic, it is, in fact, misogynistic. So, yeah, you're full of shit, and you're a fucking liar, and you don't even know your own damn fucking history about women. So how's that, Anita? You sit there and bitch about how you're promoting the female gender roles in video games, and then you're using old-ass examples of video games like Mario Brothers. Or I should say Super Mario Brothers. You're using Donkey Kong. You're using Dragon Force or Dragon Brothers, whatever that side-scrolling beat-em-up game was about. You know, where it ends with the chick actually breaking the balls of the guy who kidnaps her. Those kinds of games. Your targeting is heavily cherry-picked. Heavily cherry-picked. To the point that you're like, well, shit. I gotta make sure that none of this exists at all. Meanwhile, completely, and I do mean this, completely ignoring the fact that majority of the villains that you face, majority of the henchmen and the mobs that spawn in, are men. It's not women that you're fighting, it's men. Very rarely do you see women actually spawn in as a mob, and if you do, they're usually a zombie. Or it's because of how that game is centered. You know, women fighting women. But yeah, it's a very heavily misogynistic gaming culture, or nerd culture happens to pose, you know, with the scantily clad women and all that other stuff. Different topic. Being a target of cybermod harassment is a traumatizing experience. Through harassers seek to deny this. One tactic of theirs is to dismiss the very idea, to say that everyone online is treated the same. Everyone gets called names sometimes. In fact, there is simply no comparison between being occasionally mocked or insulted online as a male anti-feminist who occupies a position of power in an overwhelming sexist patriarchal culture, and being a woman who receives the never-ending torrent of abuse while fighting tooth and nail to create an online culture that is a little less misogynistic and a little more equitable.
Equalable? Oh my goodness.
Well, you know... I've already said it before. Sargon's not anti-feminist. Or I should say, he's not anti-women. He's not sexist. I know that for a fact. I mean, if he is sexist, he wouldn't have actually gone to your panel at all. Like, real sexists would not participate in listening to your bullshit. They wouldn't give you the time of fucking day. You're, as I said before, the low-hanging fruit. You are the lowest of the low-hanging fruit.
And I'm going to go ahead and point this out to you real fast. Being a target of cyber mob harassment is a traumatizing experience. Yeah, it's so traumatizing for you that the FBI that you had looked through your comments and emails and such told you to not fucking worry about it. Yeah, the FBI that you said, I'm being harassed, I'm being mocked, I'm being threatened. And they told you, yeah, it's not a serious case, get on with your fucking life.
Though harassers seek to deny this, one tactic of theirs is to dismiss the very idea, to say that everyone online is treated the same. Aren't you dismissing that very idea yourself? Because you are stating that you're the only person in this article. You're stating that you are one of the select few people who are being harassed and tormented on a daily basis because of your ideals.
Oh my gosh! I'm a woman, and I'm a feminist, so that makes every one of you anti-feminist and misogynist! Because, wham! I can't take my feelings being hurt!
This kind of shit has been going on since the dawn of the internet. I know this for a fact because I've said it before and plenty of times, and I'll say it again. When I started playing online video games, you were still in fucking diapers. Well, more or less, you weren't having access to the internet at that point. When I was starting to play online games, you didn't know how to access the internet. I've been online longer than you have, and I've seen this shit happen a lot longer than you have. I've seen guys in an AOL chat room. Oh my gosh, AOL, how long has it been? In an AOL chat room, literally demand pictures from all the hot bitches in the room. Like, literally, that's what he said. So, I sent him a picture of my dog. I've been in chats where people have called me a fucking moron, where people have harassed me, and people have said, yeah, you're fucking dead to me. And I just told them, bring it. I have been on games where 16-year-old boys will go, oh my gosh, you're a girl. Oh my gosh, you're a girl. Oh my gosh, you're a girl. Thinking that it's the funniest shit ever. And my response is, oh my gosh, you're retarded. Yeah, imagine that backlash. Or my favorite one is, go make me a sandwich. Okay, would you like anthrax or arsenic with that? Literally. You are not the only victim to online harassment, so shut up about it! You're not the only victim to online harassment, so stop acting like it! Women are not the only targets to being harassed online. There are plenty of men, Sargon of Akkad included, who get the same treatment thrown back at them by your 1,500 fans. So, overall, shut up about being harassed. You're not the only one, and you're seriously discrediting everybody else who goes through the harassment. By saying only women go through the harassment is fucking bullshit. I've seen the online harassment people have given my friends. I've seen the online harassment people have given my boyfriends. And I don't stand by that shit for a second. However, despite the torrent of harassment, I recently made a conscious decision to participate more regularly in panels and conversations at public or conventions at public events because I wanted to engage with people who show up in good faith to listen to our ideas. Couldn't that be what Sargon and his, what did you call them, lackeys were actually doing at your panel? We're just there to show up in good faith and to listen. Because honestly, if Sargon really wanted to say something to you, he would have done so right when you sat your ass down before you got a chance to speak. He would have stood up, mocked you for being the fucking cunt that you are, and then walked out of the room, leaving everyone to either boo at him or laugh at his comment to you. What you did, Anita, is just human garbage behavior. No, not even human garbage. That's fucking ghetto trash. But let me make something very clear. When you have a history of harassing someone for years, you show up in the front row at their panel with a camera and an entourage, that is not an act of good faith, to put it mildly. That is itself an act of harassment and intimidation. He and his companions were doing this not just to me, but to other women as well. Women like Cat Black and Francesca Ramsey, both whom have looked past the fact that they were there in general and continued on with their panel without calling either group members out. Because if I remember right, Chris and Andy Worski were both right there next to Sargon, and they both target Francesca Ramsey for her racial statements, calling it out what it is, bullshit.
and they do a very good job of that. And you know what? Francesca Ramsey didn't say anything. Anything. She didn't say a damn word to either Chris or Andy Worski. Why the fuck did you do that to Sargon? No, seriously, Anita, why the fuck did you call out Sargon like that? Out on a panel against harassment. Oh, that's right. You're a human being who's been constantly tormented by online harassers, and you're only one of the few who actually suffer with this.
So that we were all aware at VidCon that this man who has harassed us and whose hundreds of thousands of followers has attacked us online for years is here watching us. It is a deliberate act to create an environment that feels hostile, to communicate to us that if and when we dare to show up in public to express the ideas that we express online, the harassment will follow us to the physical world as well. I'm calling horseshit on that again and again and again and again. Because if he was literally there to harass you with his physical presence, he would be showing up to other conventions and other speaking places you've been attending to for the last 7 years. Not just to VidCon. He would have been following you around. And at that point, yes, that would be stalking. But he doesn't do that. He went to VidCon because, one, it's about YouTube content creators. He didn't go to VidCon for your fucking ass. He went to your panel to listen to what women of the internet have to say about women being harassed online. We're not the select few who fucking go through this shit, so balls up and shut up. He went for himself. He was listening for himself. The people around him were all YouTube content creators, all who have actually followed with Sargon on several of his points. Several of them would disagree with him on several of his points too. But we're all able to commit and communicate greatly because we don't sit there and call somebody out at a harassment abusive words. Honestly, I seriously think you set this whole shit up. As soon as you saw Sargon of Akkad, you knew, hey, this is a great way for me to get attention again. Because you were being irrelevant. So instead of saying what you were originally going to say, you called out Sargon of Akkad. Why? Because you knew Sargon of Akkad would tweet it out. You knew it would be recorded. And you yourself decided to set yourself up as a victim. As you've done with TJ Kirk's own page about how he was trying to get the Women's Health Organization more money to help women in third world countries versus you getting money to line your own fucking pockets. You have Sargon of Akkad sitting in the front row. You took the opportunity to open yourself up as a target, and you did so in such a successful way that the backlash of it is biting you in the ass, much like it's done so in the past. You make yourself the victim. Overall, I think you love being the victim. You love the abuse and the torture and the torment that you go through because you know it is a form of attention. And as long as you are getting attention, why the fuck would anybody else care? You, Anita, are just as bad as the people who use suicide for attention. Probably even worse, and I really hate it. I really hate it when people use suicide for attention, diminishing the real problems that suicide occurs and the real victims who have actually committed suicide. You're one of those people. You are an attention-seeking whore. You use harassment and online for that. You literally had triggered
not Sargon, but his fans into giving you that fucking attention, because as long as it's attention, you don't care.
Now, he and his followers are acting as if me publicly calling him a garbage human is the equivalent of what he has done to me. In truth, he and his followers cannot begin to imagine what it is to have constantly beg for and fight for your basic humanity in a culture that is fundamentally refuses to acknowledge it. He cannot imagine what it is to spend years and years being a target of floods of harassments and hate, and then to still go out there and keep fighting. The companion of his who had made that apology video I referenced earlier also tweeted that women are powerful enough to deal with things like workplace harassment and rape, as if power is in accepting a culture in which women are second-class citizens, in which misogyny and workplace harassment and rape are the norm. Fuck that. I never settled for that. You're damn right I'm powerful. After everything I've been put through by Carl and other men just like him, I'm still powerful enough to go out there and try to change it. No, you're not powerful, Anita. You're an attention-seeking, cock-sucking whore. That's what you are. Your nose is a fucking camel's nose. You'd probably bend your back, you bend over backwards and allow Sharia law to come through and show you what real rape culture is like. All the while trying to classify the nerds in general, which is the, anime fans, the video game fans that you love to target so fucking much, and anybody else in general of that genre. Anyone who's classified as a nerd, you like to target them and classify them all as being misogynists. You are a suicide attention-seeking whore. If nerds are misogynists, then you're a suicide attention-seeking whore. And I'm going to leave that at that. I'm so sorry this went on for so long. I'm so sorry for all the rantings, you guys. I hope you do enjoy it. I will leave a link to this article in the description below. Until next time, this is Tiki Palmer signing out. Peace.